welcome to St. Robert Bellarmine Parish. God gave us the gift of his Son so that the good news of his kingdom would be available to all the nations of the world. As his disciples, let us accept the challenge to carry on the work of Jesus as we give praise and thanks during this liturgy. Please stand as we begin our celebration with our Pastor Father Serva. Our gathering song is All Our Welcome.
Which surpassed Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, observe what is right, do what is just. For my salvation is about to come, my justice about to be revealed. The foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, ministering to him, loving the name of the Lord and becoming his servants, all who keep the Sabbath free from profanation and hold to my covenant, then I will bring to my holy mountain and make joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and sacrifices will be acceptable on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I am speaking to you Gentiles. Inasmuch as I am the apostle to the Gentiles, I glory in my ministry in order to make my race jealous and thus save some of them. For if their rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance be but life from the dead? For the gifts and the call of God are irrevocable. Just as you once disobeyed God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience, so that they have now disobeyed in order that, by virtue of mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God delivered all to disobedience, that he might have mercy upon all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Hallelujah. My sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon, and behold, the Canaanite woman of that district came and called out, "Have pity on me, Lord, son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But Jesus did not say a word in answer to her. Jesus' disciples came and asked him, "Send her away, for she keeps calling out after us." He said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and did Jesus homage, saying, "Lord, help me." He said in reply, "It is not right to take the food of the children and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their masters." Then Jesus said to her in reply, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And the woman's daughter was healed from that hour. The Gospel of the Lord. My friends, oftentimes we want immediate results. Whatever it is that we ask God for or we ask for in prayer, we want immediate results. And when we see the Canaanite woman being persistent in asking Jesus for her daughter to be healed from the demon that was tormenting her daughter, she remained persistent in asking Jesus, "Lord, help me, son of David, have pity on me." What did his disciples ask him? "Send her away, for she keeps calling out after us." It's so quick, isn't it, for us to put up walls, if you will, or barriers between one another. Even the disciples wanted to keep her away from Jesus. And Jesus said, "Bring her to me." Then he explained, "It's not right to take the food of the children and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Please, Lord, even the dogs eat the scraps from their master's table." And when Jesus looked at her faith, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." Jesus, all he did was look for her faith. Great is your faith. That is how important faith is to believe. And even in the persistence of the woman's faith, she relied upon the power of Jesus, and we're told her daughter was healed from that hour. And so, my friends, as we listen to this very powerful gospel today, let us think about our own faith and how we need to be persistent in asking the Lord for whatever it is that we need. "Lord, help me." And it's because of faith that Jesus can do what he wants to do for us, because we believe. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light,
ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world. Today's gospel shows us that no one sincere pleas to the Lord will go unanswered. And so we have the confidence to bring our prayers and petitions to God.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer for the church, that we may be a house of prayer for all peoples, welcoming everyone who seeks the Lord with a sincere heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our leaders, that they may observe what is right and do what is just, and in doing so, lead us in pursuing justice and goodness for all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For immigrants and refugees around the world who seek a better life for themselves and their families, that they may be kept safe from harm as they learn to call a new nation home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering from the summer heat, especially children, the elderly, and those in ill health, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all our prayers spoken and unspoken, for the sick and homebound, and for all those in our special attention book near our cross, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for world leaders, that God may give them the grace to work together during this pandemic to promote justice and special care toward the poor and vulnerable, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all who have died in Christ, for the Murphy family, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for others we would like to remember, let us pray to the Lord.
God of all, we trust in your extravagant grace, unlimited by limitations, unbounded by boundaries, foreign to no one. Listen to the prayers we offer for all our sisters and brothers, and grant them according to your will through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Take me, O Child of God, be.
itself through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Taking of the body and blood of Christ,
we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church. Spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, all the clergy, religious, and faithful people. Remember the Murphy family, also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
With the Lord there is mercy, in him is plentiful redemption. Let us